Welcome to RPV City Talk. RPV City Talk is brought to you by the City of Rancho Palos Verdes to inform the community on recent city matters. RPV City Talk is a weekly show that features the RPV mayor, city council, or city employees.
Hi everyone, I'm Liz Brown Swanson, and welcome to a special edition of RPV City Talk on the road. I'm here with our mayor, Susan Brooks, at Terranea Resort, the beautiful Terranea Resort. And we're excited to tell the community about coming here on May 5th, Cinco de Mayo. The City of Rancho Palos Verdes is going to celebrate a big birthday, turning 40. The city's 40th gala will be here at Terranea, and we're gonna tell you all about it. I know, Mayor Brooks, you're working very hard to coordinate. What's gonna happen here for the 40th celebration?
Well, we are really looking forward to this, Liz. Thank you for having me. We, as a city, we're just so blessed to be living in paradise, which is my set phrase. But I have to say, to have Terranea and this facility here at this time, and these people so gracious and willing to accommodate us, we will be having a fantastic evening with a big band dancing. The theme is 40 and fabulous, if I can show you this little card. And we are drinking, by the way, non-alcoholic drinks to celebrate.
So cheers to being 40 and fabulous.
Cheers to being 40 and fabulous with our virgin cosmos.
But gorgeous.
But we will be working with Terranea, and we already have signature foods from the five restaurants from Terranea, which will be featured, along with gourmet foods, I might add, premium wines, and the premium wines will be quite nice. And we'll also have the Tino Productions, which are rated as the number one big band in Southern California. And they do Disney productions, a variety of other activities as well. But these people will get everybody up dancing and having a wonderful time. And they play every type of music. So we're really looking forward to a fantastic celebration to really honor and acknowledge those people who helped to put this wonderful city together. And not just this city, because it's really a whole peninsula-wide activity, because the city was formed by the other cities.
Right.
So,
and we're going to talk more about the founding and all that went into founding RPV back in 1973, but I want to keep talking about the party, maybe with having these fun drinks in front of us. You mentioned, okay, there's going to be a wine reception, there's going to be an amazing big band, there's going to be gourmet food from all five signature restaurants from here from Terranea, but on top of it, there's going to be an art exhibit.
We're going to have an art exhibit. Art exhibit will also feature a plein air painter. We're hoping that Dan Pinkham will be able to accommodate us and join us at that activity. And there will also be exhibits from our Los Serenos of Point Vicente, the docents at Point Vicente Interpretive Center. So it will be a very unique and wonderful experience of the whole peninsula. And it's also here to benefit these, we're also here to benefit these two nonprofits.
So part of the proceeds will go to Los Serenos, to Point Vicente's organization, but also to the Palos Verdes Peninsula Land Conservancy.
Yes.
We'll receive some, and of course, the Land Conservancy is celebrating their 25th anniversary. So we have lots of milestones in our community this year, which is really exciting.
Along with the Vanderloop 100th.
I mean, it goes on and on. Lots to be excited about. It's going to be a really fun night. It starts, I think, is it 6 o'clock here?
Yes, 6 o'clock to 7 o'clock.
You're dressed very 40s and festive right now, I think it's suggested coming your 40s attire or cocktail attire,
but whatever you do, just come and enjoy yourselves. And we really want the people to have fun. It's going to be a lot of fun.
And it sounds, by this big band sound, you need your dancing shoes.
Yes, it does. And people, by the way, will be going home with a very nice gift accommodation. So.
Well, we're really excited. I know you're here for the 40th. You were mayor when the city celebrated its 20th, so you're getting all the fun parties. Well, but I don't know how you're doing that.
I don't know how that happened either, but, you know, and it's just worked out that way.
What are you thinking is going to make that gala so special on May 5th?
I think the fact that we, and we also have, by the way, Senator Rod Wright, who is just burst of enjoyment, entertainment. He is very bright, and he's going to be our MC for the evening. Sure that he's going to be able to really lead the group into a fantastic event. But this, I think the highlight of this evening will be the food, the wine, the people coming together, the camaraderie, the dancing. It will be all of these things. This is largely meant to be a celebration, Liz. It's not meant to be long-winded speeches. So, don't worry about politicos making long-winded speeches.
She gets up there that night. It's going to be quick, and people watching right now, they want to get their tickets. What's the best way to do that?
Go to the RPV website. You can go to palaceverdes.com/RPV, and you'll see right on the front page, it will say, Fabulous 40 and Fabulous.
There you go.
You'll see this. You click here, and you can pay for your tickets that way.
How about people? Could they actually stop by City Hall?
Yes, you can stop by City Hall. Yes, you can. You can pay for your tickets at City Hall. But just make sure you try to get them in as soon as you can, because the event is coming up quickly. It's May 5th, and we really want to have as close a number as what we're anticipating.
Aren't tickets available at the door? I'm not sure about that, because I thought I saw an April 26 deadline. You're trying to get people.
We're not going to be accepting tickets at the door.
Right, and you probably won't. This event we're pretty feeling is going to sell out. I mean, how can you beat this incredible venue here at Terranea? You know, what a place. And with these,
we're looking for 300 people.
That's
music, by the way, is going to feature all music, not just 40s music.
Okay.
It will feature music from this company does everything. They will.
The fact that this is the city's 40th milestone, you know, for you, what is so important about that? Like where we are in the year 2013. The city of RPV.
That the city has managed to maintain its low density despite all the challenges that the city faced in incorporation. I mean, there was going to be, according to Fred Hess, who was the one of the key founders of the city, and he was the mayor of Rolling Hills at the time. And by the way, I might add that all the cities participated, but the city of Rolling Hills, every single homeowner was assessed, every single parcel was assessed help in the incorporation of Rancho Palos Verdes, and that's pretty significant. But Fred Hess put yeoman's effort into this, and
which is why we have Hess Park. I know my kids, when they said he was the mayor of Rolling Hills, but he's being honored in RPV.
Right.
Well, that's why, because without him and the efforts of the community.
And so when we look at that, and I think, well, yeah, here we are at Terranea, we're able to maintain this spectacular ocean resort area. I mean, it was marine land, which was wonderful, and I was one of the people who fought to help save it. But I must say that what we have ended up with here is probably the best possible thing.
We are so happy to have this resort.
And this has really helped to fund our infrastructure. We have put it into our reserves. This is extremely important. They just reached the $10 million mark. $10 million have been raised in transient occupancy taxes as a result of this wonderful facility. A lot of this has come back to the city, and it has been a tremendous boon because we were established as a low tax-based city. And when you are established, only 6% of the property tax dollar goes to the city functions, you have to realize how much more is actually needed for our infrastructure and our other key issues.
So we want the community to keep supporting having this unbelievable
Absolutely. Come
resort.
Here, come to Nelson's, come to Catalina Kitchen.
And of course, reminding everyone out there when they come to that, the event for the city celebration, you're going to have all the best gourmet food from this resort, from all five restaurants,
yes.
Including Marcel, their signature restaurant.
That's right.
No one's leaving here hungry. To go down a little bit of memory lane, especially newcomers to the community, to really understand like why this community was driven to incorporate, take us back there. What was really going on that the need to form a fourth city on the hill started?
Well, actually, I think it started as early as 1962. And when people saw the need for something with the county, because there was this ultra inquiry to build, make an extension of the South Bay condominium corridor. And Fred Hess was one of the people who saw that when, in the first round of the battle where the League of Women Voters got involved, he realized that, oh my goodness, after that initial one failed and the county got involved and they came back and said 13,000. Right here at the coast across from Forestall. And he likened this to Hong Kong. He said there will be more people per square foot than there would be in Hong Kong. So when you make that association, you might be able to see a very, very different community, which is why anybody coming to Los Angeles can clearly see how spectacular Palos Verdes is, because it is unlike any other place in Los Angeles. It is not concrete-laden Los Angeles, I put it.
Right.
It is, and the proof that, so spectacular.
And the proof that what the founders were after in terms of controlling the development on the coastline and to keep it low density is that really the city has the same number of residents today,
exactly,
40 years later, as when the city first formed.
That's right, 42,000.
It would be, look very different if this didn't happen. If
yes.
Yeah.
It would look very, very different. We would probably be over 150.
And it was amazing, the fight that they, I mean, they
can imagine it.
And the effort to put this together, like you said, it started in the 60s and it took over a decade. You had organizations that formed. It started with the League of Women Voters, right,
yes,
going out and doing the homework on what's going on with zoning from the county.
And I might say it was, yes, mostly women who helped to put this together, Dorothy LeConte and Betty Strauss-Field,
right,
and
a lot
Barbara
of women.
Walsh, and so many of these women who really were the backbone that really were putting this together. But Gordon Curtis, clearly, and Candida helped to put this together, and the first city council then served, and it was just a very much of a community family. And
right,
I might say the whole Palos Verdes Peninsula. So,
but of course, the organizations, the Palos Verdes Peninsula Advisory Council,
right,
that was all the homeowners in the unincorporated area that were trying to go to the county and saying,
yep,
you know, we don't want high density. And then, of course, that led to the forming of the Save Our Coastline Group, which,
right,
really pushed it forward. I mean, it ended up going all the way to the state Supreme Court,
yes,
to finally get the green light to become a city.
And then 5-1.
Yeah.
We won. 5-1, I mean, on a vote by the residents, 5-1.
So.
And so it was, the odds were huge, and it was overwhelmingly applauded to start this fourth city here on the peninsula.
And of course, guests that come,
and largest,
and the
city,
guests that come to the gala can learn about this, because they are going to have some historical exhibits,
yes,
and sort of take you down memory lane to show you what was involved. But
and they're going to get a DVD.
Okay, they
and
are.
So
RPV
the DVD,
TV is working on
RPV
that.
RPV TV is working on the DVD.
That's going to be getting
and
lots of
And we have
of
a special
fun.
Gift bag that we're putting together.
What are you most looking forward to that special night, May 5th, here at Terranea? What are you most excited about?
I'm just excited about, I love to dance. So I'm really looking forward to dancing. I am a dancer, so Dancing with the Stars is my favorite show outside of anything political.
It's going to be a great night, and we want to keep reminding everyone, May 5th, here at Terranea, the 40th Gala, 40th Fabulous. Again, the website, go to the city website.
The city website. You can go to palosverdes.com/RPV and you can get right to the ticket.
Or stop by City Hall, of course, all these things. Anything you want to add as we sort of start to wrap it up, just to remind everyone we're so blessed to live in this community and to be celebrating 40 years.
No, we are. And we want to look at the next 40, not too many changes.
Many of the founders have passed, but then
yes,
the ones that are still around, I remember we just recently was talking to like Barbara Gleghorn,
yes,
and
Betty yes,
Field Strauss,
yes,
and all of these like women, as you say, that worked really hard in the trenches. They're all going to be there at the party. So
yes, it will be really wonderful to see all these people.
All
so,
right, yeah.
But this particular, this is a celebration. This is a party. 20 years ago, we had it at the Vanderlip Estate, and it was lovely there, but we were very limited in the number of people that we could accommodate, and the food is going to be far superior, the entertainment far superior, and we will not be using porta-potties.
Oh, there you go. That's good to know. Not when you're here.
Which was, well, you know, the elegant ones, but they were very nice. It was a lovely event, but I have to say this is... And it's a comparable price, actually, and 20 years later.
Yeah. And again, remember, too, when you come that night, part of the proceeds go to two great organizations,
yes,
the Land mm-hmm. Conservancy and Los Serranos.
So thank you.
I want to remind them. And so, well, it's always
so
great.
So we're excited about it. So
yeah.
I'm already
she's
partially
all,
dressed.
She's all ready to go. And I know she's got her dancing shoes on, and we're looking forward to a fun, fun night. And we'll see you
thank
back
you,
there.
Liz.
And hopefully they'll
thank
make
you
us
and RPV
another
TV
beautiful
and
beverage like this.
Thanks to Terranea for
yeah, here we go.
Being
cheers
on
to
this planet.
Terranea.
Thanks to Rob Lowe and all the wonderful people who helped us.
And it being 40 and fabulous, right?
Together.
Are we 40 and fabulous? Yeah. I love
oh, yeah. I'm 40 and fabulous. And so
there
are you.
You go.
Again.
Love that theme.
We could be the new Kathy Lee and Hoda.
We'll try. But I look forward to seeing everyone. I'll be there with you at the gala. So we'll see you May 5th here at the Terranea Resort. And thanks for joining us here on RPV City Talk. Thanks for being here, Mayor.
Cheers.
And there we go. See you next time, and see you at the gala.